Okay. Respected Chairman and Director of Instruction Course of this session, this Gullapalli and Rao Endowment Lecture, this five endowment lectures introduced first time by AOS this year, although it doesn't fit into this program what you are going to have, but you have been told to talk for 10 minutes about his. So, good vision is a basic human right, and sight is our most powerful sense. Corneal ulcer resulting in corneal blindness is a public health issue, mostly neglected at the cost of other blinding eye diseases. That Rao has published a recent article in IJO last month. So everybody should read about that, about Indian ophthalmology, about corneal ulceration. And I was associated with him for about 37 years. Even before he started LVP, he was at Madurai to inaugurate our cornea clinic. At that time, cornea clinic run individual one is not common. So I just run for 3 hours every afternoon, and Dr. Rao and my mentor, Dr. James Acuella, were there for inaugurating. And after that, he was there in 2014 to receive Dr. G.V. Oration Award. So as per publications in 2005 by Rajesh Sinha et al., so in 2020, that is this year, we are having 10.6 million corneal blindness unilateral. I don't know if it is correct or not, but this was the one projected. And also other international people interested in prevention of corneal ulcer and prevention of corneal blindness, also they have recently published it is increasing. So if you look at that incident survey, US, Europe, Asia, Africa, all these countries, even in developed countries, the microbial keratitis, particularly bacterial and fungal, its incidence is going up. And especially in India, we see close to 1 million new corneal ulcers every year. Trachoma was that prime cause for corneal blindness and vitamin A deficiency. But by powerful preventive measures like SAFE and azithromycin, and mostly it is, I won't say it is eradicated, but it has brought down a lot. So now corneal ulceration is leading as the silent epidemic, especially in Asia. Now recently, James Chodas, you know, he's from Boston, and he has taken a lot of efforts with international cornea people, and he is now bringing with WHO as a corneal ulcer. It's a neglected tropical disease next to leprosy and all those things. So why should we prevent corneal ulcer? We have powerful antimicrobials, especially for bacterial keratitis. We are able to kill the organism, but the end result will be the scar. So this 10-year-old boy now in that eye is blind or severe visual impairment, but next thing is corneal grafting, and you know the outcome in pediatric keratoplasty. So this guy recently, 30-year-old, had pythium keratitis, is emerging now. It is very difficult to treat. There is no cure now. Mostly, most of them, 99%, they go blind. This after 1 year, I have treated, healed, resulting in a scar. So unlike in cataract or diabetic retinopathy, glaucoma, corneal blindness mostly involves young people, adults, mostly children. So prevention after corneal abrasion, we have time and again proved, not only in India and other countries, that if you treat any corneal abrasion within 24 to 48 hours with basic antibiotics like chloramphenicol 3 times a day for 3 days, 98% you can prevent corneal ulceration. If you miss that, then you see the bottom slides, that's the end, even if you treat in a tertiary care center. We have proved with different publications that you can, at village level, grassroots level, training a village health worker, you can prevent corneal ulceration. And this is a mega study done, just completed in Nepal with the help of NIA funding. It's called VIEW, Village Integrated Eye Worker Trial. And it involved 2 million population, 3-year study, randomized. Now the results will be published in few months or next year. Then you will find out with the control group if you give antibiotics what happens. Then about eye banking in India, you know, first eye bank started in New York in 1944. Then Second I Bank was started in India in 1945 at Madras Eye Infirmary. Madras Eye Infirmary is the second to Moorfields Eye Hospital, started in 1819, and they have just recently celebrated 200 years. And we have about maybe 400, 500 eye banks, mostly registered EBA. EBA was started in 1989. Then Dr. Rao pioneered the HCRP pilot program at Hyderabad, and now it is such a successful project. Yes, time and again they have demonstrated, and you get your utility will go to 70% to 80%. And Toha was tough initially. Now they have amended so many amendments and bills. Now the 2011 Toha amendment is more favorable for eye donation, especially except doctors. Previously we can't do an excision. Now all mostly ophthalmic personnel, nurses, they are permitted to excise the cornea, and again they introduced request law. But see that organ donation was in India even Dwapara Yuga, that is 5,000 years before, and Kannapa was the pioneer in eye donation, and he is a donor and a surgeon. So he enucleated his eye and grafted his eye. So it's very popular. Organ donation is not new to India. And Sight Life and Eye Bank Association of India, when I was president of Eye Bank Association of India, it was projected that in 2020, you need 100,000 corneas for grafting. To have 100,000, you have 200,000 corneas. In 2025, you need 2.5 lakhs corneas, but the situation is, even last year, you get only 56,000 corneas, and utilization is only 26,000, less than 50%. South zone is doing better, but north and the west zone, east zone, they have to improve to get that target. So if you want to achieve the target, this pyramid mostly, I think, recommended by Dr. Gullapalli Rao and other group, EBAA. So you should have 5 training centers, the top eye banks, center of excellence, then 45 eye banks, then 2,000 eye donation centers. Through this, you can harvest 200,000 corneas. So now we have cornea distribution system. Sight Life is promoting that. Last year, we have been able to distribute tissues in more than 50 cities. Nearly 300 surgeons are registered to us. So EBA and Sight Life India is facilitating CDS. So if any corneal surgeon, you want a cornea, if you contact them, they will supply the tissue. And the Ministry of Health is more favorable. They're helping a lot. And registry for corneal transplantation is the requirement for the time. And there is no problem with Government of India running an eye bank now. And in future, so I don't recommend any new eye banks. I don't want any new eye banks. We have 500, 600 more letterpad eye banks. Do we meet the demand? No, definitely not. We are meeting only 1/4. How to procure 1 lakh donor cornea? That I showed the pyramid. You follow that, you can get it. To implement HCRP in all teaching hospitals, so you should have MOU, even NGOs, charity hospital, not for profit. You have to go to government hospitals, get MOU. And now the demand for pre-cut tissue is increasing, and India also we are making now, we are supplying. There is a future. It's just like intraocular lens. Even a cataract surgeon will get the tissue, pre-cut tissue, and he can tackle his own phakic or pseudophakic bullous cataphthy. And tax exemption for storage media now for carnisol produced by RO Lab, we are giving about, what is that, 20% tax. A lot of money goes for the tax. We are working on that, and the AIOS can work on that. And bioengineered cornea, it has come now. It's not a theory or something. It is there in all the eye banks, most of the eye banks. Then gamma irradiated corneas. So these are the future of eye bankings. Then corneal blindness, you can prevent eye banking. Still, you need that. Till you achieve the target, I request all these people involved in prevention of corneal blindness to increase eye donation and train more cornea people. My sincere thanks and deep regards to chairman and members of scientific committee AIOS, and also the instructors of this program. Thank you very much.